Well, I never knew it was such hard work.
You know, one summer when I was in the Alaskan oil fields, I waited on tables the entire summer. Yeah, and all I remember is my feet, sore feet.
I know. Soaking them at the end of the day is my greatest pleasure.
Well, you look like you're holding up pretty well.
Thanks, I am. Especially thanks to Ada and Maisie, who have been very patient. Believe me, I'm a lucky woman. I am, of course, a lucky independent woman.
Yes. Mary, if there's ever anything that you need.
Thank you, Michael.
Or if there's anything that I can do.
I'll let you know.
Excuse me. I was told I could find a Mr. Michael Hudson here.
Oh, you found him.
You and your daughter, Nicole Love, are needed immediately to testify in the Brittany Love case.
Look, it'll take me a couple of minutes to round them up.
Please, as soon as possible.
Okay, fine. I think Vicky should be at home working.
I need to be surprised.
Mary is what?
She's waiting on table.
Don't be ridiculous, Victoria.
I swear, Grandpa, she is a waitress at Mary's place.
You saw this?
Yes, yesterday.
Well, I'm going to put an end to this madness right now.
The role of Rose Livingston is now being played by Anne Flood.
Where else would I be?
Well, I thought you had that lunch date with the Brazilian consortium.
Oh, right. They called and canceled.
Oh, and I suppose you were planning on a leisurely, non-working lunch.
Sounds to me like you're going to put an end to that right now.
I really could use an okay on these numbers.
Later, okay?
Is something wrong?
Well, I was supposed to join Rachel later. She's across the street there at the courthouse testifying in the Brittany Love case.
I'm sure that's very unpleasant for her.
Perhaps not. She has friends there. Mitch Blake among them.
Are you going to testify?
I hope so. I'm not crazy about sitting around a courtroom. But I know Brittany needs some people around her who are on her side. But the sight of juries and guards brings back a few too many memories for me.
Yes, I'm sure it does. Well, I'm sorry. Excuse me.
All right, maybe I shouldn't have yelled out about the rape, but I couldn't help it.
Forget it. I just hope the jury can.
Wait a minute. Why won't this work to her advantage?
Yeah, it's a clear reason for self-defense. It's a motive for attempted murder.
I checked out the jury when Brittany yelled it. A couple of them looked at Peter like they knew he was guilty the whole time.
We need all 12 to believe that, Gatlin.
Okay, then maybe we should put her on the stand now.
It's wishful thinking, and I don't blame you for it. But I want to play this my way and stick to the order of witnesses.
Brittany will go first.
By the time she gets on the stand, I'm hoping that all the sympathy will shift toward her side.
All rise.
Is the defense prepared?
Yes, Your Honor.
All right, proceed.
The defense calls Dr. Jamie Frame, please.
Call Dr. Jamie Frame to the stand, please.
Now you're going to get yours, you pig.
Hold on a second, bailiff. Before we go any further, I thought that after yesterday's outburst, and the day before, and the day before that, I thought I'd give everybody the morning off so that we could kind of settle things down and kind of bring this trial in the manner befitting this court. I have been tolerant, more than tolerant up to now, but that is coming to an end this afternoon. Mr. Edwards, you are to instruct your client to remain silent until told to the contrary. And if she can't handle that, she's out of here. Is that clear?
Very clear, Your Honor.
Swear him in, bailiff.
Raise your right hand. Do you solemnly swear the testimony you're about to give is the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God?
I do.
State your name and occupation.
Dr. Jamie Frame. I'm a doctor of medicine.
Be seated, please.
What is your area of expertise, doctor? I'm a family practitioner with 2 years of experience and training with battered wives and abused children.
And where and when did you meet the defendant?
I'm affiliated with a clinic on the west side. Mrs. Love came there about 2 months ago.
Why?
Her child was ill, running a high fever.
And in your course of treatment, did you find that Mrs. Love required attention?
Well, it didn't take an expert to see that she wasn't a well woman. She was terribly underweight. She had no color. She was suffering stomach pains. I found her to have a pre-ulcerous condition.
And in the course of examining Mrs. Love, did you find anything else?
Bruises over various parts of her body.
Did Mrs. Love tell you how she suffered these bruises?
Well, not then. But over the course of subsequent treatment, I discovered that an atmosphere existed in her home that contributed to this.
An objection, Your Honor. What exactly is an atmosphere?
Good question, Miss Lazarus. Let's try to get the facts out here, Mr. Edwards.
Doctor, what exactly did Mrs. Love tell you?
That her marriage was deteriorating. And so was her health. I was very afraid that she was going to suffer a nervous breakdown, a total collapse.
And what did you do about it?
The only thing I could do about it, I talked her into taking her child and moving in with my mother.
And she readily accepted it?
She realized she had no choice. She was terrified of her husband and very afraid for her child's future.
Your Honor, I cannot allow these insinuations. Did Dr. Frame actually see Peter Love put these bruises on his wife?
Well, I think you can hold that off until cross-examination, Miss Lazarus. At this point, I'm rather inclined to permit Mr. Edwards some latitude anyway. Proceed, Counselor.
Thank you, Your Honor. One last question, Doctor. In your medical opinion, could abuse, if allowed to be continued, be considered life-threatening?
Well, I've had it. I can't wait any longer. I'm going.
What if Nicole and Vicky show up? Should I give them a message?
Yeah, please. Tell them I went to the courthouse and tell them to meet me there.
Sure.
Thank you.
Michael, where are you going?
I'm going to testify. Now, where have you been and where's my daughter?
Oh, I got stuck in traffic. She probably did, too. Look, why don't we wait a minute, okay? It doesn't matter if we're a couple minutes late, does it?
Stuck in traffic? How long do you think she's going to be stuck in traffic?
2 minutes, okay? She's going to be really upset if we don't wait for her.
She's going to be upset? I've been waiting here half an hour.
2 minutes, Michael, please.
Hello, Nicole.
Mary. Are you working here now?
Yeah, I'm a waitress.
I'm trying to learn how to be a waitress. I have a lot to learn. I have mastered handing out menus, however. Would you like to see one?
No, thank you. I'm too nervous to eat.
Look, I'm going to try to find Vicky. I'll make a call.
This must be terrible for you, being called as a witness. Zach Edwards is asking to testify against my brother. I feel so disloyal. Do you think I'm doing the wrong thing, Mary?
I think it's admirable of you to want to tell the truth, and I don't think you should punish yourself for that.
Well, no luck. Look, if she doesn't show up soon, I don't know what...
This is all so sad.
Well, it seems like the Love family has been surrounded by nothing but sadness lately.
How's Donna? Is there any change at all?
No.
I pray for her a lot, for both of you.
It's that Reginald, you know, he tried to tear this family apart and he's damn near succeeded. Mary, I'm sorry.
Okay. I understand.
Maybe we better get over there, Michael.
Where the heck is Vicky? Oh, we gotta get to court. See you later. Let's go.
Bye.
You may only testify to what you actually saw, Dr. Frame.
I saw those bruises, Miss Lazarus.
Which could have been caused by any number of things. A fall, bumping into something. Poor health is not evidence of abuse. I'm sure you've seen countless cases of individuals whose health is suffering and they have no one to blame but themselves.
Your Honor, is Miss Lazarus presenting her final argument or is this lengthy statement part of her cross-examination?
No further questions, Your Honor.
No redirect.
You may step down. Dr. Frame, thank you. Call your next witness, Ms. Redwoods.
Mrs. Rachel Corey.
Call Mrs. Rachel Corey to the stand, please.
terrific, totally believable. Even on a cross.
Peggy was trying to blow a smoke screen, but Detroit didn't buy it. You could see it in their eyes. Score one for the good guys.
State your name, please.
Rachel Corey.
And for those few who might not know, would you tell us who your husband is?
Mackenzie Corey.
Now, that's a really excellent job, Rose.
I don't believe that.
Well, it is. I'm very impressed.
You didn't even read it.
Well, I looked it over very well.
Mac, these numbers are not to be looked over. They're to be studied, cherished, embraced.
I'm sorry, Rose. I was never one to embrace a quarterly budget report, I'm afraid.
Can you handle study and cherish?
All right. How soon do you need it back?
An hour ago.
Looks like I'll have to take it to lunch with me then.
Oh, Mac, I'm sorry to do this to you.
No, it's quite all right. Keep my mind off other things.
Mac?
Hmm?
I thought you'd want to go to the courthouse, be with Rachel.
And watch her shoot down my testimony of the other day?
Yeah, I guess I can see how that would be uncomfortable.
Besides, remember, I've got a luncheon date with Mr. Debit and Ms. Credit.
It doesn't sound terribly exciting.
You're right. It isn't. They're very humorless, these two.
Well, in that case, why didn't I join you? I mean, it might make lunch a little more palatable. And I promise I'll laugh at all your jokes.
Well, there might not be too many of them. I'm not very good company these days, Rose.
I'll be the judge of that. Mary's place?
You're on.
Between the two of you, who was closer to Brittany Love?
I was considerably closer.
Did your husband dislike Brittany?
Oh, Mac doesn't dislike many people, and Brittany certainly wasn't one of them.
How would you characterize his feelings toward her?
Indifference. I mean, he didn't really know her. He knew her only through Peter.
Peter Love is very close to your husband.
Well, Peter works for Mac. He has done for years. They have a very good relationship in and out of the office.
Could you describe it as a father-son sort of relationship?
Well, some people have. Mac is very fond of Peter. He has high hopes for him at Corey Publishing.
So he's very protective of Peter.
Objection.
Sustained. Let us not leave the witness, please, Mr. Edwards.
Yes, Your Honor. Mrs. Corey, let's turn to your relationship with Brittany. Would you consider yourself her confidant?
Yes. She would come to me to discuss things that were on her mind. I would do the same.
Did she ever mention that she was afraid of her husband?
Several times.
Physically afraid?
She had been afraid of Peter for months.
We heard prior testimony about bruises and signs of abuse.
I saw bruises on many occasions.
Didn't you inquire about them?
Yes, I did. And when I would ask Brittany if Peter was responsible, she would change the subject.
Was there any doubt in your mind that Brittany Love was a battered wife?
No, none.
Thank you, Mrs. Corey. Your witness, Counselor.
I only have a few questions, Mrs. Corey. Did you ever see Peter Love strike his wife?
No.
And you testified that Mrs. Love never told you he did, and yet you're certain that she was a battered wife.
That's correct.
Well, I have serious doubts about your ability to ascertain that.
Was that a question, Miss Lazarus?
I'm sorry, Your Honor. Mrs. Corey, did Brittany ever mention to you that her husband had raped her?
No.
I understood you to say that you were her confidant. Don't you think the reason she never told you she was beaten or raped is because it just didn't happen? It sounds to me as if Brittany went to a great deal of trouble to set up this abused wife fable.
Objection sustained.
No further questions?
No, wait a minute.
That will be all, Mrs. Corey. Thank you.
No, it's not all, Counselor. I'm not finished.
Yes, you are, Mrs. Corey. Thank you.
Wait a minute. Are you saying than a man that could draw all
You're
the child
out of
custody
order, Mrs. Corey.
And force his wife to sign it. Are you saying that that
Mrs.
Is
Corey
is incapable of beating and raping
Mrs.
his wife?
Corey,
Your Honor.
You're out of order.
Does this court have absolutely no interest in the truth, Your Honor?
Now, look, Mrs. Corey, contempt of it means something, and you're just a hair's breadth away from it. So please, madam.
I'm sorry, Your Honor.
May I redirect, Your Honor?
No questions that lead to any histrionics, please, Mr. Evans.
Miss Lazarus keeps harping on the fact that no one ever saw Mr. Love actually hit his wife. Do you think it very likely that he would invite anyone to watch?
Oh, Your Honor.
The jury will disregard Mr. Edwards' grandstanding, but I assure you, the court won't. You were asked to redirect, so now, Mr. Edwards, do it.
Did you witness any arguments between the Loves?
I witnessed exchanges of words. On one occasion, I interrupted a full-blown fight.
Did you hear what it was about?
No. When I asked Brittany, she wouldn't tell me.
Why would that be if Brittany was setting this all up?
Brittany Love lived in terror of her husband.
And here I thought you were so professional.
Now, just a minute. I've been trying to talk business ever since we got here.
Really? You name me one time you've even mentioned that word. And, you know, we haven't so much as glanced at Mrs. Debit and Mr. Credit.
I thought it was Mr. Debit and Ms. Credit.
You have an incredible mind for detail.
No, seriously, Mac, don't you think you ought to start looking at the numbers, see if you have any questions?
I'm afraid I just can't concentrate on numbers right now. This is much too pleasant. Matter of fact, this is the first time I've relaxed in weeks.
Well, it can't be business problems. Corey is as flush as it's ever been.
No, not business.
Oh, I hope there's nothing wrong with your family.
No. Well, yes. One member of the family, Rachel.
Oh, she isn't ill, I hope.
Oh, no. She's in fine health. It's my marriage that's ailing.
Sorry.
Not that I've given up hope, but right now.
I noticed you haven't seemed yourself lately.
Rachel and I'll pull through it. We always do.
Well, if you ever need to talk.
Thank you.
Hi, ready to order? Reginald.
Do you hate me this much, Mary?
How did you know I was working here?
Are you doing this to hurt me?
No, of course not.
Well, you have to give it up.
I don't have to do anything. How did you know I was here?
Victoria told me. Mary, this is humiliating.
I don't find anything about my independence humiliating.
You call this independence, waiting tables?
I think I was lucky to get this job.
Lucky? Mary, please, it doesn't make any sense.
I have to go back to work.
I can't let you do this. Listen to me. Mary, please, don't do this to me.
I can stall.
Look, Zach, I've left messages for Victoria everywhere. She's got to get one of them.
I need her testimony, Michael.
Come on, Vicky, where are you?
You are keeping the court waiting, Mr. Edwards.
Oh, one of my witnesses is late, Your Honor, with the court's indulgence.
Court has overindulged. There is a limit to the court's leeway.
I understand that, Your Honor. But if you could grant me a brief recess, it's vital that I present my new witness in the proper way.
Your Honor, please. I'm sure she'll be here any minute.
Who are you to be so sure?
I'm her father.
I don't care about her paternity. Just her testimony. Call a recess for 10 minutes. When the court reconvenes, you will call a witness.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Undo some of the damage?
Well, I think it's going to take more than friends getting up to root for her, Mom.
Yeah, but I think Zach knows what he's doing.
Yes. Zach's a good man.
Well, I guess we can go, huh? You want to take your mother out to lunch?
I think I'd better stay here and keep tabs on Brittany.
Oh, that's probably a good idea. She might need you. I'll check in later.
Oh, by the way, where's Mac?
Well, he's supposed to be here, but he didn't show up. I'll be over at Mary's place in case anything unexpected happens.
Okay.
I don't mean to bother you, but I thought you were going to call me early in the defense.
I've changed my mind.
Why?
Well, I'm not going to call you at all.
Because I'm an ex-con?
But
it's all right. It's all right. You're not going to hurt my feelings.
It's too risky at this point, Mitch. I mean, you'd be a powerful witness for Brittany, but putting someone on the stand who's got a record and who's on parole...
That's all right. I'll be here if you need me. You're a good parole officer, and from where I'm sitting, you're doing as good a job as anybody could.
Well, thanks, Mitch. I appreciate it.
5 minutes, Mr. Edwards.
Yes, Your Honor.
Toria, where are you? I don't know how you do it, Rose.
But...
no matter how low I feel any day, you always make me smile.
Oh, that's quite a compliment.
Well, I mean it. You have such joie de vivre. People love to be around you.
What people?
Well, I love to be around you.
Well, that's really very sweet of you to say, Mitch.
Well, I mean it.
It's funny.
What?
I just don't see myself as the type to have that kind of effect on people.
Really? How do you see yourself?
Oh, as a somewhat lonely woman, a widow who's trying to make sense out of her life, trying to, have a career and be father and mother to her children all at the same time and not doing very well at it at all. I'm sorry, does that sound too self-pitying?
Not at all. Sounds very honest to me.
Well, I think it is getting easier, though.
How long is it now since your husband died?
4 years ago, last week. My daughter, Sarah, took it hardest. I wanted so badly to be able to help her, but, you know, it's very difficult sometimes to help your children when you're in so much pain yourself. I mean, I had all I could do. Anyway, I really feel very guilty about it, and I wish I hadn't been so selfish.
But you did the best you could. I mean, a single parent, working full time, you mustn't be hard on yourself.
I try not to be. Children are children. And then there's Sarah.
Where is she now?
I'm not sure. We had a disagreement a while back. The first I've seen of her in a long time was in a picture of her outside the courthouse. She was testifying at the Brittany Love trial.
That's your Sarah?
Time is up, Mr. Edwards. This court is reconvened.
Wait till I get my hands on that girl.
If you don't have a witness here in 30 seconds...
Yes, Your Honor. Your Honor, Miss Victoria Love is the next witness for the defense.
Call Victoria Love to the stand. Raise your right hand. Do you solemnly swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God?
Okay.
I do, is what you say.
Oh, she does. Just let's get on with it.
I do.
I'm terribly sorry for the delay, ladies and gentlemen. Miss Love, could you tell the court your relationship to the defendant?
She's my aunt by marriage.
So Peter Love is your uncle, is he not?
Yes, he is.
On the afternoon of October 28th, did you overhear your uncle threaten to kill the defendant?
No.
Probably not.
the next part of Another World.
I have used this gavel more times in this case than I have in my combined years on this bench. Now, we're all going to settle down and listen to Mr. Edwards and this witness. Go to it, Counselor, please.
Miss Love, on that afternoon 2 months ago, what did you hear?
What Peter said to Brittany?
That's correct.
Like we talked about?
In your own words, whatever you recall.
Well, before you asked if Peter threatened to kill Brittany.
Your Honor, the question was asked. The witness said no. I submit that her response was clear and immediate.
Well, let's see where it's going, Miss Lazarus. That's it.
Thank you, Your Honor. That day, what did you hear?
Well,
remember that.
May just make everything worth it.
And just remember, darling, you better be a good girl or you might not live to enjoy all that money.
Is that a threat?
You'd better believe it.
You won't live to enjoy all that money.
And then Brittany asked, was that a threat?
To which your uncle replied,
you better believe it.
I apologize, Miss Love, for such improper phrasing of that first question. I'm sure the jury will recognize my honest mistake, since the threat of killing Brittany was so implicit.
Call Michael Hudson to the stand, please.
Do I like Peter Love?
You don't, do you?
She's putting words in the witness's mouth.
Because he insists on answering a question with a question, Your Honor.
A simple response will suffice.
Your Honor, whether or not I like Peter Love has nothing to do with my testimony.
Simple, Mr. Hudson, simple. Yes or no answers, please.
Okay. Yes, I don't like Peter Love.
Thank you.
Mr. Hudson, since you are now a member of the Love family, you must be aware of a struggle going on behind the scenes to gain control of the powerful Love holdings.
Oh, must I?
Are you aware of such a struggle?
Look, you couldn't be more wrong, Counselor.
Sorry, Judge.
Look, the answer to your question is no. There is no power struggle going on that I personally am aware of.
Very well, Mr. Hudson. No more questions.
Redirect.
Yes, Your Honor. Since my esteemed colleague is attempting to cloud the issues with irrelevant questions, I'd like to back it up to the reality of the situation. Did you hear Peter Love say that Brittany could ruin his life in any minute if he did not kill her to stop her?
Yes. Unless he killed her to stop her.
Rachel.
Oh, please, don't get up, Max. Sit down and enjoy your meal.
What are you doing here?
Same thing you're doing, I guess, having lunch. How are you, Rose?
Won't you join us, Rachel?
Oh, no, thank you. I wouldn't dream of interrupting your business lunch.
But I thought you were testifying.
I already did. I thought you were going to be there.
I changed my mind.
Obviously. Excuse me.
Please, Rachel, sit down with us.
I don't really want to eat. I'm not very hungry all of a sudden. I'm going to go back and see how Brittany's doing. Big day for the defense.
She seemed quite angry.
Yeah, I don't blame her. I mean, I was supposed to join her. She walks in, here I am having lunch with you.
Oh, I feel as if this is my fault.
Oh, no, don't be ridiculous. I'm the one who's embarrassed.
Why?
Well, I mean, I was just telling you about problems with my marriage. Rachel walks in, it's like a big joke.
Mac, never feel embarrassed in front of me. We're friends, remember? And friends share things.
You're not supposed to be back here.
Neither are you, Mary. You don't belong in this place.
I will decide where I belong.
Can't you see what this is doing to me?
It's not my concern, Reginald. Not anymore.
I see. Then you don't care about my feelings at all.
can't believe you're trying to make me feel guilty.
I am trying to make you see that I love you, that I care about you more than anything in this world.
If you care about me, you will let me go back to work.
Mary, no.
Let go of me.
Worse when I get done with her.
And nothing but the truth?
I do.
You see it? Miss Love, you are the sister-in-law to the defendant?
I am.
Then Peter Love is...
my brother.
Could you tell us about the baby, Miss Love?
My brother took the baby from Brittany, and he also threatened that she would never see little Peter again.
You have done everything! I'm never going to be free! I'll be a slave to you as long as you're alive.
That is the bottom line, isn't it? And as long as you're alive, I'll always be in danger. You can ruin me.
That's really all I can tell you.
Thank you, Miss Love. No more questions.
Miss Lazarus?
Thank you, Your Honor. Miss Love, would you please describe your relationship with your brother?
I love my brother.
Haven't you spent a great deal, in fact, most of your life apart from him?
That doesn't mean I loved him any less.
It wasn't the question, Miss Love.
We were separated, yes.
And yet you claim to have this love for him.
I do.
Do you consider your appearance here today a demonstration of that love?
I am telling the truth, that's all.
Yes, the truth about a situation and a relationship that you know virtually nothing about.
Look, I am telling you what I saw and heard. I am terribly upset about what happened. But I was witness to something. And I am telling the simple truth.
You're still here.
Do you really think you can reject me that easily?
I'm not rejecting you. I'm doing something for me.
Making the minimum wage. Whatever you need, you only have to ask.
You stop that. You are not my husband. I have to do this myself.
It's absurd.
All right, it's not just for the money. My family is here. I need time with them. I need to get to know them again.
All right, fine. But don't I deserve some time? You say you're not rejecting me, but you won't see me. Mary, we spent 17 years together. Wonderful, loving years.
Which are over.
Not for me. Never for me.
Everything has changed.
Not my love for you.
You make this so difficult.
I want it to be difficult. I want it to be impossible. You want your independence? Fine. But waiting on tables, that's nonsense.
It is not. It makes perfect sense. It may well be the only thing that has made sense in the last several months.
I love you. You love me. That's the sense of everything. That's the reality. The rest is pretense. Why can't you see that? We were meant to be together. Destined.
I am making a new life for myself. This is where it starts.
Did well up there.
I don't think I've ever felt worse in my life.
Are you prepared to call another witness, Mr. Edwards?
Yes, I am, Your Honor. But I would ask the court to grant me a very brief conference with my client.
Very brief? We're talking the briefest, Counselor. This trial must move along.
The defense calls Brittany Love.
She took care of Brittany Love's baby in our house. She is a very charming young woman.
That doesn't sound like Sarah.
You mean you don't think your daughter's charming?
No. I mean caring for a baby. It doesn't fit somehow.
Well, she seemed very conscientious to me, and the little Peter just loved her. It was wonderful the way she took care of him, really.
I wonder where she is now.
You mean she hadn't contacted you?
No, she wouldn't. I tried to contact her through the court.
No luck?
No, I was too late. Now she's just dropped out of sight, and I'm really worried about her, Mac.
Well, don't be.
Don't be? What do you mean?
I guess that sounded callous to you. What I mean is, I'll have her located for you.
You will?
Sure, I'll get my security people to work on it right away.
Oh, Mac, thank you.
Well, I haven't done anything yet.
Oh, yes, you have.
What?
You treated me to lunch.
Oh.
You've shown an interest in my daughter. But most of all...
What?
You've been my friend. And that means very much to me.
Mackenzie Corey, I would like you to try to locate a young woman for me. Her name is Sarah Montaigne. Montaigne. M-O-N-T-A-I. Sorry, I'll have to get back to you. Yeah, right away.
You don't have to hang up.
Oh, no, I can call later. Rachel.
Well, I saw Rose leave the office. I thought it was safe to come in.
It's always safe, Rachel.
Well, I wanted to apologize if I seemed abrupt earlier at Mary's place.
No, you were fine. I thought you were rushing out to see Brittany.
I was. I just didn't want you to misinterpret anything.
Misinterpret what?
Why I wouldn't join you and Rose.
No, not at all.
Good. Well, did you accomplish a lot with Rose?
Yeah. Yeah, quite a lot.
Well, she seems like a real good friend.
Oh, she is. And believe me, right now I can use one.
What do you mean by showing up late at the trial? You could have damaged Brittany's case.
I didn't get the message until late.
Look, I just talked to Bridget. She gave me the message in plenty of time.
What? I had to get gas, though, and there was a line.
Vicky, I don't want any more of your excuses, all right? I'm sick of those excuses. Just tell me why you were late.
I was scared.
Of what?
Of testifying. I don't know, I was afraid I'd say something wrong. I don't want to hurt Peter. I don't want to hurt Brittany. I don't want anybody to get hurt.
Oh, it's okay. It's all right.
Everything's just falling apart.
No, it's not. Everything is getting better.
What about Donna?
Honey, she's getting better, too.
Who says?
Says I. And you can take that to the bank. As a matter of fact, while we're speaking about making people feel better, I have an idea about how to make a certain special someone feel a lot better. You want in on it?
Oh, what?
Tell you what you do. Pick up that phone book there, flip through the yellow pages, and find a florist. We are going to send 2 dozen of the longest stem roses to a Mrs. Michael Hudson.
Make it
three dozen. Make it a dozen dozen.
I like your style.
Since Mrs. Love is such an important witness, I'm going to recess this court for 15 minutes.
All right.
Zach, can I get Brittany out here for a recess?
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Where can I take her?
The waiting room should be empty.
All right, go ahead. Come on, let's go. All
right. How do you think your trial is going?
Just get out of the way.
When you take the stand, are you going to talk about the rape of my...
All right, come on, man. Let us out of here.
How did you figure out who the baby's father was?
Just shut up.
I read where you had another child with Catlin Ewing.
When did Peter Love find out you'd been unfaithful to him?
All right, I'm telling you to back off.
All right, take your seats or I'll have your press passes revoked. Let's go.
How old is your first child?
Jeff.
Drowned out west, right?
No more questions.
All right, listen, I'm barring from this courtroom.
Why didn't
back.
You report the rape when it happened? Maybe it didn't seem like a rape then, huh?
Back off. Back off there. Back off. Back off.
This part of another world was brought to you by Butter Flavor Crisco. It gives baked and fried foods a rich butter flavor you'll love.
Tonight on a holiday highway to heaven, it's a night of miracles in a new Christmas classic. Then, from the creators of St. Elsewhere, the dramatic conclusion of a year in the life, it's NBC's special holiday tribute to the American family and the best movie ever to make you cry at love and laugh at life. Tonight.
Join us each weekday for the continuing story of Another World.